Kia ora, nomai hoki mai, welcome back. Now, be honest, how many of you, including you, have filled up the car with the wrong petrol? I'm guessing, yeah, that's what I thought.
Just the once.
Yep.
But have you ever bought the wrong gas without even lifting the nozzle? Hmm. That's what happened to a first-time user of Z Energy's petrol app. What's more, she wasn't allowed to switch. Caitlin has the story.
Donna was having a day, forgetting a significant something.
Nothing.
At the worst place in time.
Got to the gas station on E for enough and no wallet.
Empty tank, empty pockets. Well, except for the cell phone she had handy, which gave her an idea.
I thought, I've downloaded the app, the Z app.
About a month back, she'd seen people talking online about the app's special feature, Sharetank.
Sharetank scans all Z stations in your area to bring you the lowest Z pump price.
You could pre-purchase at a cheaper rate, get the best rate, and use it later.
But on that fateful day in Avondale, Auckland, Donna wasn't wanting to bag a deal for the future. She needed fuel then and there. Only she'd never used the app before, so she asked Z staff for help.
Stood next to me and led me through the app, telling me what to scroll through, what to hit next, and led me through the purchase.
Did they offer any tips, any warnings?
No.
So what they told her next came as a shock.
I lifted the Bowser. He said, actually, it's 95 you want. I said, no, I use 91.
She'd never been asked what fuel grade she wanted.
I just said to him, can we undo that transaction or change it, thinking it would be a simple process?
Far from it. Z Energy's terms and conditions state Sharetank balances cannot be sold, refunded, transferred or exchanged for cash. So even after calling Z up, there was no back button for Donna.
It's telling me that they don't have the ability to turn that transaction around. He keep calling it Sharetank litres, and I pointed out it was actually a Visa transaction.
Z had only one solution. She could gift her litres to someone else with the app.
Not my intention, standing there next to my car with no petrol.
And having exhausted her weekly gas budget, $102.
That was it.
Fairgo knows of other Z customers who've purchased the wrong fuel using Sharetank. So, in this digital age, what responsibilities do companies have to make sure their apps work for everyone? We put that to the team at Journey Digital.
So if you just have a look here.
A developer that creates all sorts of apps, websites and software.
How obvious do features on an app need to be?
They need to be at the forefront, they need to be easily found, easily discoverable for all types of users. If it's not really clear to the user, they essentially remain hidden and undiscoverable and they won't be used.
Donna says her Sharetank settings were set on premium 95 by default, and it was the same for Dane and I.
You've got the 95 at the top there, and then my two main actions are at the bottom. It'd be nice to have grouped those together. And the buttons are blue, which is the same as the background, and so from an accessibility or an impairment point of view, it's quite hard to see that I need to make a choice there.
When you click over to the next screen, there's another chance to change the fuel type, if you can spot it.
What is not explained is the fact that I need to swipe between them if I wanted to adjust that.
Z Energy says the fuel grade selected remains visible throughout the purchasing process, including this final summary screen. But that might not be enough to ensure everyone's clear on that, especially given how many of us buy gas.
Designing for different demographics, from young to old, from learning impairments to visual impairments, sometimes those don't sit nicely with beautiful brand execution, but they are important to maintain a fair level of customer service across all of your customers.
Let's not forget, in the real world, gas stations already know the importance of spelling things out.
They've got things in place for that because people do it all the time.
Donna resigned herself to putting the word out on our show.
I can hook you up with a tank of 95.
But thankfully, Fairgo seemed to push the right buttons with Z.
We recognise we could have escalated this case following the initial customer call to resolve this matter promptly.
Z's now refunded Donna her $100 and offered a $50 voucher on top. But the company told Donna that's only because she was a first-time user and wasn't given the right advice at the time. Its policy on refunds and exchanges still stands.
The primary reason we don't enable transferring Sharetank litres between fuel grades on a user's account is that different grades have different prices per litre that change regularly at any given Z station.
But Z Energy has taken Donna's feedback on board ahead of launching an updated version of its app later this year. Being heard in the real world beats any savings Donna would want in the virtual one.
There's an app for everything, isn't there? Yeah. Look, I'm very pleased we got there in the end for Donna.
Technology, supposed to make life easier.